and welcome to Dreamland Fun Park in Margate. We're here today in partnership and conjunction with the Save Dreamland campaign and all of the CoasterForce staff. We're going to be here riding the Scenic Railway as part of our support for the campaign. Dreamland actually opened in 1920. Is home to the oldest operating roller coaster in the UK, which is behind me, the Scenic Railway. Now, on the 1st of March 2002, the Scenic Railway was actually awarded Grade 2 listed status, which basically it means it's the UK's first amusement park ride to ever achieve this. And it was Nick Laister who lobbied to achieve this goal, so a lot of credit is owed to him for keeping this open and getting it into a listed status. Okay, Dreamland took a substantial blow back in 2003 when the owner basically announced that the park was to close and to be redeveloped as something that could possibly be not an amusement park. And this is where the Save Dreamland campaign actually began. And to tell us about the campaign, we're going to be talking to Dave Collard, who is actually a prominent member of the Save Dreamland campaign, and he's also worked on the Scenic Rail as a brakeman. There'll be more about that later on in the feature.
Hi Dave.
Hello. You right there?
Yep. Okay, so how did you get involved in the campaign, if you can remember?
Well, I was in 2003, I was working at the bar, and just saw something in the paper when Sarah Vickery and Nick Laister first got involved in a meeting with the council. So I contacted Nick Laister, and obviously kept him informed of what was happening in the bar. As time went on, it lasted a lot longer than I thought it was going to.
So that's basically why you got involved.
Well, I've always been very passionate about the park, and obviously here the park may close down, and if I can do anything to help, then I will do.
So what are the latest developments of the campaign?
The independent inspector at the inquiry last year said that the park should be protected as an amusement park. The council have chosen to go against that. There was, on the whole local plan, there was 452 objections and 442 were regarding Dreamland. And they have still chosen to go against
that. They're ignoring what everyone's saying.
It seems very much they're ignoring the independent inspector, the inquiry's evidence, all the objections. But we have managed to have a meeting with the council and they have agreed that there will be a test as to financial viability, because they've said that the park will only be developed so if an amusement park is not viable. But we want them to be a bit more clear on what they mean by viability. So obviously, even though the webs are running the site this year, they're doing their best, we can't base evidence on the park being open for a few months.
Yeah, I mean it's half built, you know.
It's pretty much like a travelling fair. You can't compare this with the likes of Philip Miller at Southend, who can do so much more. So there is an amendment there to say what they will accept as evidence.
So what is it they want to do with it though? I don't understand. Why is it the council is so adamant they want to get rid of this?
Well, they're going by the previous owner's assumption that it doesn't make money. So they want something that's going to attract people. But obviously, being downsized and only open a few months a year, it's not going to make as much money as it could. I mean, it was put up in the inquiry that it's mainly down to management, poor management issues as to why the park is not doing so well. So
obviously Godwin decided to...
Since Mr. Godwin's taken over, the park has been downsized to hell of a lot.
So what is it you like about the looks in the Scenic Railway? What is it that you think, and why is it you feel so passionate about it?
I've been interested in the park since the bedrock days when I was a kid. As soon as I leave school, I went to work at Dreamland. My dad saying, "Oh, you don't want to work at a fun fair, part-time job." I started off working on things like little kiddies at the coaster when I was 16. So I'm glad I'm going to stay here. I haven't been working away to talk about it. That's it. I'm 30 back, but it's taken a while. But yes, I got there eventually. I mean, it was the last operator on the big wheel before that was sold. The biggest rides that have been here. Not many people can say say what to do for a living and drive a roller coaster. Not many people can say that.
There's only two of them in the country that need a roller coaster.
So if there was anything you could do or say to sort of the enthusiasts about getting involved, what would it be? How is it best for them to get involved?
Well, to register on the website at safedreamland.co.uk, click on the Join Us link. Link placed will inform you what to do and when to do it. So we'll keep you informed of what's happening.
Okay, excellent. Thank you very much for your time. Roller coasters as a concept were developed by Lamarcus Thompson, who was basically involved in the original development of the switchback coasters. Now, the idea behind a scenic railway coaster was to make a ride where the passengers could imagine or enjoy an imaginary scenic tour. They featured elaborate puzzles like the ones on the railway and would involve a lot of elaborate scenery and landscaping and hilling. Basically, a technique that is still used today and is heavily emphasised in the theme park industry as theming. Now, one major difference with the scenic railway is the train has no under-friction wheels, which basically means there's nothing keeping it on the track. So should it go too fast over one of the hills, the train would career off the track. Bearing this in mind, the brake ramps are employed to keep the speed of the ride in check. Okay? The brake ramp actually sits on this ride between the first and the second car, as you'll see when it comes round in the moment. The operator will brake there behind me to make sure that it doesn't go too fast. Slows down just enough to get over the hills, but not so fast it comes away. Okay. Now, of 127 wooden coasters built in the UK between 1885 and 1960, only 9 of them still are in existence. Thankfully, since the 1970s, there has been a little bit of a resurgence in the interest. You know, there's more people wanting to ride wooden coasters, and which obviously in turn is helping to increase the request for wooden coasters to be built. I mean, there are only 3 woodies have been built since the 1960s in the UK. But like I say, only 9 of them survived from the original, this being the oldest. And obviously all of this combines to tell us why the scenic railway is an important part of the UK seaside resort history and also a piece of real roller coaster history. Now actually going on a tour of the ride with Mr. Webb, the managing director of the company that actually owns and runs Dreamland at the moment. Wandering around?
Yeah,
we're now going into the main shed.
Wow. Every nut and bolt is stripped from the trains. We've got new bearings, some new axles, wheels, new brakes, all the way through.
Yeah,
the trains, to make sure
that we're completing our revamp every year.
Yeah.
It wouldn't look right. It's all clean and tidy. This is the
train. Yeah. Thomas Station. New anti rollbacks, new wheels, new bearings. The bearings we have to make ourselves. White metal casing. You basically got the bearing. You fit each axle individually. And you melt white metal. So to get perfect fit on the bearing, that way you get a smooth running gear.
Can't get the right rails
in. Yeah, unfortunately. This is the old knowledge of things with stripped down and discarded from the train.
Yeah,
because they're out. You just rebuild the main metal. So our old colour wheels, because in case the air took off and replaced with new. These are 2 old trains that are out of use. They stopped running under the 80s.
Right.
No, they're just donor trains.
Yeah. How many enthusiasts want to get their hands on one of them?
Yeah. How many trains do they run at once?
It used to run 4 trains at once.
Yeah.
But we run 2 trains at once when we're busy.
Yeah.
It's not for the weight. The approximate weight of that train when it's fully loaded with people goes approximately 4 tonnes. So we keep 2 trains on it. We could run 4, but older fans get onto it.
No, it is looking a bit uncomfortable to sit on.
surprised a restaurant or something hasn't bought Blackpool. Because I mean, in Blackpool you've got like the Coasters restaurant itself.
No,
obviously it's not our place to sell because we're only leaseholders.
Ah, right.
It's part of the heritage. I believe it should stay in the pub.
Yeah, it's all
definitely.
Basically, it's maintenance shed. You can see in there just how old everything is. The smell of grease in there was amazing. So you can tell just how old the ride is, and obviously how enthusiastic the people running the park and like the managing director, how much they look after the coaster.
Okay, we're now going to talk to some of the CoasterForce members about what they think of the Scenic Railway. So first up is our manager, our wonderful Ian Bell. Enjoying the weather?
Loving the weather.
Good, good, good. Now, you've not long been on the Scenic Railway. What did you think of it?
It's very charged. It wasn't as thrilling as I thought it would be. It's just very charged. It's just very lovely ride. Right?
Pretty enjoyable. What did you think on the smoothness and the roughness of it?
It was incredibly smooth. I like my wood to be a bit rougher. That, I thought, was just maybe a bit too smooth. Because I like it hard and fast.
Fair enough. Okay, so why do you think that Scenic should be safe and still be here in terms of
Scenic? Well, Margate has been a dead town. If they got rid of this, it'd be a travesty because I'd rather have something which is charming like that.
And keep it with tin head shots and stuff like that.
This is just, this is unique. This is the crowd. The ship is safe. Bloody just horrible. Worst mistake.
Thank you very much, Ian.
Pleasure.
Okay, now welcoming Phil, who's another CoasterForce member, also known as Fury on the forums. How are you, Phil?
All right. How are you today?
I'm fine, thanks.
A bit hot. A bit hot, very hot. Okay, so you've not long been on the Scenic too. What was your initial thoughts about it?
It's very, very interesting. It's fantastic to go on a coaster with such a uniqueness about it in this country. There's nothing like it that I've ever been on.
It's excellent. So obviously you're celebrating this being your 100th coaster today. So why does that make it extra special for you?
Because it's also the oldest standing coaster in the country. So it's kind of, as I'm moving forward through my amount of coasters, I'm moving back in 3 times to the oldest coaster in the country. It's also special with it, you know, being under threat of closure. So it makes it more special that, you know, I can capture it if it does close down.
So why do you think it should stay open, like, as a park and obviously the Scenic Railway as a monument?
As an amateur historian, I think that trying to keep any kind of reference to the past, especially 20th century, so early 20th century, working class holidays, that kind of thing, it's all being eradicated completely, and this is one of the last bastions where you can actually see what that used to be. You know, it's great as a living museum to those kind of times, something that we don't get anymore with package holidays and all the rest of it. I think it's very important to try and keep these places alive as our own personal history.
And so, obviously, you will have seen the I Dream of Dreamland plans for the future, or what could possibly be here for the future. Would you be inclined to return if those plans went ahead?
Definitely, yeah. I mean, it's a long way to come just to ride a single coaster with a few fairground rides, but to come to see a full park, full operating park, would be wonderful. And it'd be great to see a place like Margate come alive again with the business and the trade that would actually bring into them as well.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Phil.
Thank you very much, Mark.
We're now going to talk to Kerr, who's one of the team members on CoasterForce. Hi Kerr, how are you today?
I'm fine, it's a pleasure to be interviewed by you, Mark. I hear there's lots of people out there who find you very attractive. And I'm sure this will go down well on your record.
Thank you very much, Kerr. Bless you. Right, well basically, you've not long lived in it. What do you think?
To be honest, I enjoyed it very much because it's a classic. It's the kind of ride that you automatically appreciate because it's been here for so long. I mean, it's nearly 90 years now, is it?
Yep, opened in 1920.
So. Opened in 1920, so obviously it's a ride that everyone's going to enjoy. It's not intense, obviously. It's a family roller coaster. You can see small children going in it. But it's got enough. It's got enough to keep you interested. Obviously, you've seen many people from CoasterForce have done re-rides today. So it's got enough to keep people coming back. I think it's a good classic. It's a classic.
So, I mean, as the Safe Dreamland campaign, would you be willing, what would you do if you could to keep the park open?
Well, I think a park like this needs public awareness more than anything else. It needs to be shown to the people in the area, like the heritage of the coaster, like how much it means to the history of the area. Because like with a lot of seaside villages, there's a lot of history that goes unknown, and obviously this coaster is a visual representation of that history. I think it's very important that it remains in the park.
So, and obviously you've seen the plans for what this place could be. I mean, what do you think of those plans? Would you like to see that happen?
It's hard to say because with the new plans, obviously you lose the history straight away. It's something like talking about the theme park or the actual.
Because I mean, the scenic would stay.
If the scenic stayed, I think there's a possibility that it would be overshadowed by other rides because an expansion. But then again, an expansion would bring in a lot more revenue. The park could make a lot of money from it. And could be beneficial for the tourists, it would bring a lot more interest to the town itself.
Yeah.
So it can work either way. Basically, if you're looking for keeping the history, then keep it as it is. But as we've seen, things are going downhill, so there's only one way forward, and that is to go ahead with the plans.
Thank you very much, Kurt.
My pleasure. Thanks very much. It was lovely to be interviewed. Hope to have the pleasure again very soon.
Okay, I'm now going to talk to Sarah, who's actually one of our members' mums. So she's not actually an enthusiast, so it would be nice to get an outside perspective. Sarah, you've ridden it, what do you think?
I think it's good, I enjoyed it. A couple of nice hills.
Yeah. What do you think of the park in general?
Looking very sad. Needs a bit more. Reduce the tokens.
They can be worth quite a bit of that. So you don't think it's
been expensive,
right?
Yeah.
Well, if the coming, I don't know if you know about it, there are by coming in and taking over the park, redeveloping it to be very much like Adventure Island in South End, what would you think of the place if they were to take that?
If
approach?
They did that, they'd be improved
Margate,
especially. You could walk along and it's all closed up, so I think it would
pull
in more people.
And would you be likely to come back?
Yeah, possibly if they did that.
I'd come back. Yeah, that's it. So thank you very much, Sarah. Okay, so that is our documentary about Dreamland and about the Scenic Railway. So you've seen the opinions of everyone. You've seen the ride itself. You've spoken to people who are part of the campaign. All that's left now to do is go on one last time where you guys are going to get the front row view.
We're now setting off on our ride on the Scenic Railway. Just pulling out of the station now, the brakeman's just jumped on. Down around the first corner where we'll meet the first lift hill. It's all good fun. So obviously, being so old and such a big part of the UK history of coasters, I mean, we all feel that it's something that should be looked after. Dreamland has dropped into such disrepair of late. And so, if the right person was to get hold of this park, it would be amazing. And this coaster, out of everything here, needs to be looked after, purely because of how old it is. Okay, we're about to go down on the first drop.
Yay! Love it. Here we go. CoasterForce! Woo!
Okay, we've got small, like, double drop.
Wow! It's lovely and bouncy. It's really rough and I love it.
Okay, we're now onto the first turnaround of quite a few actually. There is a few turnarounds on here.
We're going a little bit faster this time. I think we're going a little bit faster.
So that's all good.
Woo!
Okay, and the second drop.
Whee!
Woo! Over the bunny hop.
great fun.
We're now going to head back on the second turnaround now, which brings us onto the second and bigger lift hill. So as you can see there, to the front of us, we have the brakeman. He's the one controlling the speed, as mentioned earlier on in the video. Random person standing down there. Yeah, hopefully. All the other CF members. About to crest the top of the second lift hill now. I'm going to put my arms up as usual. CoasterForce! Woo! So let's take the second double top. A slightly bigger speed there. Obviously, nice and pounding. That's what's great about a wooden coaster. You feel every last nook and cranny in the ride. It's great. Woo! Second bunny hill there. Oh. Oh, into a double drop. And that one always takes me by surprise. I always forget that that one's there. It's madness.
Yeah. Tree grab.
We're now basically pulling back into what could be classed as the brake run. That's the Scenic Railway. A classic ride. And obviously this is one of the main reasons we want to see Dreamland saved and kept open, purely because of how much of a fun ride it is. You can see it for yourself how much fun we had. So I think everyone should come down and see it.
Woo! Woo!